Hello everyone, and thank you so much for joining me here today. My name is Eve, and I'm going into the messages on this lunar eclipse in Gemini. I started talking about this yesterday on my Instagram channel, and that information is below. I pulled three cards from the Hero's Journey deck. I'm doing a series on messages from Mars on my Instagram, so you may want to go and check that out, because I feel like some of those messages are going to speak to you. And the Hero's Journey is guiding you onto the pathway that you are meant to travel at this time. These are simply messages of guidance that I bring in that you may or may not choose to follow. The other thing that I put up on my website today is my most recent lecture, which is a wrapping up of 2020, a moving into this eclipse corridor within the signs of Gemini and Sagittarius, the winter solstice, and the Jupiter-Saturn alignment at 0 degrees of Aquarius here occurring on the winter solstice. So do check that out. That's on my website. All of that will be in the description box below, and that's up there for purchase. Now, this is a lunar eclipse in the sign of Gemini, which is an air energy. And air is always about the mind, our thoughts, our beliefs, our forms of communication, and how we go about our daily routines in terms of moving from point A to point B. So the air signs rule the idea that we are out and about and interacting with people, whether we're speaking or going places. So it's a very active and energizing element, all of the air signs are. And in Gemini, there's usually a lot of discussing of things or thinking deeply about situations or communication in one's life. But Gemini is also about learning, getting educated, finding the messages that you need, looking through the internet, reading books, going to classes, looking for what you need so that you can make a well-informed decision. That is very specific to Gemini, which is the seeker of information. It's also the disseminator of it. Whereas Sagittarius is how to take all of that information and then create a book of knowledge and wisdom and experience with it. So Sagittarius takes the information gathered and create something else with it. And so during a lunar eclipse, we have both energies. We have the moon in Gemini, and we have the sun here in Sagittarius. And so what I want to suggest that you all do here, because an eclipse literally means that in the lunar eclipse, it is the moon's energy that is being eclipsed by the earth, because the earth is coming in between the sun and the moon. And what that is providing for you here is a grounding mechanism. So it's directing you to ground your energy, because the moon, especially in Gemini, can be information coming in at lightning speed. It can be things moving very, very quickly. And with the earth eclipsing that energy, she is guiding you to slow it down, that a delay right now might be better than movement forward, depending on your instincts here. You've got to listen to your intuition, because an eclipsed moon is telling you that your thoughts are one thing, but in this case, you've got to go deeper within and listen to your inner guidance. That is where the truth lies here. And to ground your thoughts within the earth. So go out, exercise, walk, meditate, go to the beach, surf, golf, play tennis, whatever it is you want to do to bring your energy into your body and ground it. And that allows your mind a focus point so that your thoughts can then become clearer, they can integrate within your body, and they can also blend with your intuition. And at that point, your ability to know what decision to make will indeed become clearer. So that's how we use the energy of an eclipse here. Now I brought out three different piles, and you can do a couple different things with them. You can decide to choose one pile, two, or all three of them. You can look at it as a message or a story here, and each one of these piles is a chapter in that story. I'm going to leave it up to you. For some, it's best to listen to all three and then just pick whatever messages resonate, perhaps from each pile. So here's the first one, and the stone is a beautiful, clear, slightly light blue fluorite. Fluorite is a beautiful stone of healing and clarity. Pile two. Now, there's a secret with this one, so you'll know if you decide to only pick this one. This is one of my rune stones, and it's an amethyst, and it has a rune on it. And the third one is carnelian. So that's a very grounding stone, but that's a sacral chakra. So that's your second chakra. So carnelian is about balance, romance, and creativity, and children as well. Okay, so I'm going to leave it there, and I'm going to go ahead here and start with pile number one, and I'll just move those over, and then we'll bring them back up. The decks I'm using are the Divination of the Ancients Guidebook, the Secret Language of Light, the Queen of the Moon Oracle, and at the very end, I have an extra guidance here from the Whispers of Love, which is going to be for everyone. So I'm going to leave that at the end. So let's look at the very first message here from the Divination of the Ancient Ones. It's the Oracle Wisdom. That is a beautiful message. It means that you already contain the answers within you. Let's see if I can get that to stand up. There we go. You contain the knowledge that you seek. And this is an invitation to go into your own inner world. And perhaps there's some shadow work that you're going to need to do here to get or to reach that deep inner wisdom that lies beneath. You can listen to other people, but you need to, at the end of the day, follow your own inner guidance. The oracle is also letting you know that just as you are respecting your own inner pathway of wisdom, it is very important that you allow other people their own beliefs and perspectives as well, so that you do not blend your beliefs or your pathway of wisdom with somebody else's, okay? So there's a message here about boundaries. We're asking people to respect yours and you respecting other people's boundaries here as well. So let's look at the extra messages here. You already know the answers to your questions. You realize that what lies behind the current circumstances, and you understand what is best for yourself. And rather than seek the opinion of others, trust that inner knowing. Like a wise oracle, you are able to see through the darkness and shed light on situations that could possibly baffle others. So this is also telling you that there's a wisdom that you have right now, and listen to that inner wisdom, and you may be guided to be that house of wisdom or that oracle for others, just as what I do as my mission on this planet. I am an oracle, and people come to me seeking that oracular wisdom. Well, perhaps you pull this pile in particular because that's what you are right now in your life as well. Or let's flip it upside down and say that you seek wisdom and you want to go to an oracle, or to an intuitive to find that extra wisdom or that extra guidance, or you need that oracular wisdom from another as a way of confirming or affirming what you already feel, okay? Now recognize here that this could be a journey into the dark chambers within yourself, for that is where you will find the insights that you need to help you on your journey. So don't be afraid to dive deep within. There is no cause to seek the approval of others, because all that you need, you have either before you, within yourself, or you have your own tools, you know, for example, your own oracle cards. You study astrology or numerology or tarot like I do, or you will perhaps ask an oracle for extra counsel here. But beyond everything else, what the two messages here are is that you are in touch with the truth in this situation. So if you are asking about a person in your life, a relationship, or a situation, I'm confirming with you right now that you actually know the truth to this answer. And don't be afraid to speak your truth either. So that's the other message here. It's time to be clear with how you are speaking to other people about situations in your life. Now let's look at the other cards that came in from the secret language of light, authentic truth. Perfect. Fits it to a T. It's time to speak your authentic truth. I'm going to leave that right there. And in order to find that truth, though, again, you've got to go deep within the chambers of your body and your heart. So we're back to that original energy that I was referring to in the eclipses in the beginning of this reading. Go within. Ground yourself. Meditate. Use the tools that you have to make sure that you're absolutely centered so that the answer comes to you clearly. Discover your truth and let others find theirs. The message here is the truth is going to set you free so long as you recognize that there is more than one truth and that the answers that you seek exist beyond the beliefs that you presently hold. Very interesting. So we're getting extra information now. This is saying that there are greater truths waiting to be discovered by you. And so perhaps you do need to study something or learn something or seek external counsel in order to get to those truths that you are seeking now. Just focus on what resonates with you. And remember that if you must convince yourself of your beliefs, then they are not your truth, because your truth will always fulfill and satisfy you. It is unconditional, meaning that conditions do not have to change for you to live and feel your truth. So the message here is very significant. It's about you trusting that you have that truth within you, and that whatever beliefs you're carrying, if some of those beliefs that you've called truths make you feel uncomfortable or unsteady, then you've got to look at them and let go of them, because they don't belong to you anymore. They're outmoded, or they're outdated. Or perhaps you were taking on a belief or a truth from someone else because it sounded good at the time, but now you're realizing that you're not comfortable with it. So your level of comfort is going to be a compass here for you. Remember, if it is not your truth, you're going to resist it in some form, or you're going to find it hard to commit to it, and you're going to feel indecisive. Okay, so always practice focusing on what makes your heart sing, not shrink. Now that is the key right there. So let's look at the last message here from the Queen of the Moon Oracle. And it's darkness. That's the eclipse right there. It's the long night moon, which is the last full moon of December. So that's actually going to be the next full moon, which I think occurs around December 28th or 29th. In this picture, though, that really looks like an eclipse to me. So I'm getting a message of timing here, that your wisdom, this journey of wisdom and authentic truth and inner knowledge that you're on right now, you're going to be on this pathway from this full moon into and through the next one. So this could be a journey of 1 to 2 months that you are currently on. And this eclipse is bringing some beautiful messages in for you, okay? I love the rabbit there. The rabbit in Native American medicine means it's about facing your fears. So it's darkness. Within that darkness, which is the void of great mystery, lies the truth. But you have to go in and not be afraid to face that darkness to find the answers that you seek. So let's look at the extra message here. It is time to do shadow work, which will bring big dividends later on. Release what no longer works for you. One of the earliest human fears is said to be a fear of the dark, but it's because we fear what we cannot see and we fear what might be hiding there. But in reality, the dark is as important as the light. In the northern hemisphere, the long night moon usually occurs in December around the winter solstice. So there's a timing message here for those of you who picked this pile in particular. And if you're doing all three, just know that there's some form of wisdom or deep inner knowledge that you are acquiring and achieving, building now into the winter solstice. It is during these long nights that we can begin to do our shadow work, undertaking the self-reflection that is needed to identify what isn't working for us and what might actually be causing us pain. This could be a bad habit, a destructive pattern, a recurring useless fear, which is often the case, by the way, or anything that holds us back from being the best that we can be. Remember, your authentic truth is going to make you sing, not shrink. And once we see these aspects of ourselves in the dark, we can then simply decide whether they must go. And we can release them finally once and for all. Because this winter solstice is a time of very, very great new beginnings. And this is a time to release the fears of the wisdom and the knowledge. And I'm getting for those that specifically chose this pile too, that this is about your mission on this earth. That this is the message and the answers that you're seeking right now. But perhaps there's a level of clarity that you have not yet attained around your mission and what that embodies, and that you're seeking deeper wisdom within the deep chambers and corridors of your being, and you're doing the shadow work to get there. I love, love, love that message. Okay, so I'm going to put that away, and I'm going to pull out deck number two here. And I want to say something, because this is the rune stone of standstill. And standstill means that at this time, there's either a delay. Standstill is you're in the winter time of your spiritual growth. And it can mean that the winter right now, as we're going into it, is a time of deep inner reflection and going within and doing the inner work for the 3 months of winter. And once the frost and the snow starts leaving and the sun starts warming it, then the spring comes, and that is the time for movement. So with deck number two, it's a little bit different than deck number one, because I feel like there's a couple different messages in this pile. For some, it's that there's a timing message, that right now it's the time to do the inner work, which does coincide with pile one as well, with part of that message, and that once the winter reaches its end and spring is coming, there'll be a lot of movement forward, and that is the time of action. And for others, what I'm getting is a delay right now is only going to benefit you, that there's something still beneath the surface that during the months of winter is growing and it comes out in the springtime, okay? So there's certainly a message around perhaps waiting or delay, or that it's not quite the right time yet. And standstill for others of you could mean that everything's exactly where it is right now and there's no need to change anything at all. It means everything is just perfect the way it is. Okay, so just take the messages that resonate most here. And the message we got from the divination of the ancients is psychometry, which is sensitivity. There's a lot of different messages. So, you know, I really do feel that some of you are picking specific piles only. This pile, I'm getting it for different people. For some, it's you're in a very deep, sensitive time right now. And so doing that inner work, taking really good care of yourself through the standstill rune, is about hermiting, caving, she caving, man caving, going inward and doing the bare stuff. You know, sleeping a lot, resting, taking care of your physical health, because I'm getting healing for some of you that you're on a healing pathway right now and that you really need to take care of your physical well-being and your mental and your emotional well-being. That perhaps you're releasing a lot of old emotions, perhaps old pain and hurt about a relationship or a job that didn't work out, okay? I'm sensing that something didn't work out and you're letting it go. So this is a card of just really recognizing where you're at and embodying that sensitivity. And I love it because the hand is reaching out to the cosmos. So know that you have so much beautiful cosmic support helping you move through this sensitive time in your life, okay? And so kind of just look at what you need most right now. And then the other message I'm getting here, it's completely different, is that there's an offer coming in, that someone is offering you their cup of love, represented by that golden ring. They're offering you an engagement ring. They're offering you their hand. They are offering you a commitment of some form. Okay, so very different message than the one I had at the beginning here of pile two. So let's go deeper in to see if we can get anything more. So from the secret language of light, we have the word enlightenment. This is telling you that you're on a pathway of ascension, okay? Again, it corresponds with really paying attention to your sensitivities right now, and that means staying away from harsh environments, maybe abstain completely from any form of drugs, even the healthier drugs like CBD or, you know, psychedelics, mushrooms, whatever they are. Maybe stay away from all of that at this time and alcohol, and just really have a very plant-based, pure diet at this time, because that's going to help you move through this faster. And enlightenment is telling you to really have patience with your journey. Number 43. Yeah, which is number 7. It's the path of ascension. Absolutely. Beautiful, beautiful message. Evolution is guaranteed. You are waking up from your old habits and patterns. Beautiful. Yeah, this is a card of awakening. That's why you're so sensitive, because you're waking up either for the first time, or this is your next ladder up, like you're going up a next very big step on that stairway to heaven, and you're leveling up is the word I was looking for. And because of that, you need to take extra good care of yourself and monitor your moods and your thoughts. And at times you may feel bewildered or not quite yourself on this journey. Relax, all is well. You are just keeping up with your evolution and the life that you desire. Your body and mind are adjusting and adapting to your new and your loving soul perspective. So there's a lot of newness coming in to how you're viewing the world right now and how you're feeling about things. It is common for the mind at this time and the body to resist, react, or panic when you experience the unfamiliar or the unknown. So again, ground yourself. I think that's the message I got in pile one as well. However, from this higher vantage, you can change any story that splits you in two to heal your wounds. You are not trying to replace a negative memory with a positive one. Instead, see all of the components of a memory so that a new conclusion can form. Because an unbalanced memory only recreates the trauma every time. And what that means is, if you only want to remember the positive things about a situation, you're actually deluding yourself. Because when you're involved in a situation where there was perhaps some positive things, but also some deep trauma, you've got to remember the memory in its entirety, because there's a lesson there in all of it, in the positive part of it, and also the challenging part of it. And when you take the whole memory and you work with it, then that's the only way you're going to fully heal anything that needs to be healed here. So for this pile, I'm absolutely getting a message of healing, okay? And just remember that to lean into your fears, to not be afraid of what's happening to you, to trust your journey, to just know that the universe has your back here. So let's look at the Queen of the Moon Oracle card. The plan is action. The waxing gibbous. Well, that often happens after a new moon. The waxing gibbous is the week before the full moon. So the time frame you're being given right now is letting you know that you've already been in this energy for at least the last 7 to 8 or 10 days, and that it's going to take you towards the next full moon, okay? The message here is action. Okay, so let's read this. Sometimes we are afraid to move forward. This is natural because change can be difficult. And if we have been hurt or we have failed before, we are anxious about what could happen. So the fear here is that the same pattern is going to occur again. And that then paralyzes us from wanting to move forward. So the message overall here is just telling you to get out of your paralysis and trust that the universe has your back, that you are indeed on the ascension pathway, that you are moving up the ladder of your enlightenment. This moon phase encourages you to embrace action because action is a part of your humanity. You are not made to hide and refuse to blossom, okay? If you remain stagnant, you will not grow. So it's time to take action here. Okay, I'm getting for some of you, there's just fear. You feel like it's safe to stay where you are, yet where you are, you're no longer growing there. Okay, and we're back to the original runestone. Okay, so for some, there's a message of timing here. For some, the action is literally within this moon cycle that already started about 7, 8, 9, 10 days ago, and it's going to take you up to the next full moon, okay, which is the end of December. So that's a message right there. For others, you need to sit with this and work it with it internally and build your sensitivity, build your physical body, your emotional, your spiritual, mental, and perhaps your financial world until the time feels ripe for you to take that action. So I'm getting two different timelines here. One is the end of this year, and for others, the timeline is the beginning of spring, the ending of winter, and sometime in the beginning of spring, okay? Very interesting timing. And also, please apply that for those of you that you're getting a message around a relationship. Perhaps an engagement, an offer that's coming to you, or perhaps new love coming in, someone offering you a commitment of some form. And I'm feeling like this is more romantic, but I'm aware that it could also apply to a business partnership. Okay? Lovely messages. So let's go ahead and move those out of the way, and let's get to our very last card here. Pile. So that's the carnelian. Beautiful grounding stone. I love it. From the ancient ones, wishbone. Affirmation, your wishes are coming true. Very interesting. Okay, just like deck number two, I'm getting two different pathways here, or two separate groups of people. One, it's absolutely a very strong confirmation that your rewards are coming. A good job, pat yourself on the back, celebrate your life at this time. You've reached the 10 of 9 or 10 of pentacles in the tarot. It's time to celebrate what you've achieved. For others, I'm getting that you're standing at a threshold where there is a decision to make and there are two pathways awaiting you, and you don't know which direction to take. So let's see what other messages we have with that, that can perhaps guide us. Okay, there could be a timing message that maybe you need to sit with it. And you know, whenever I get that feeling where both pathways look equal, that's when you want to step back from your logical mind and you want to go into your intuitive body and ask your body and your heart which feels better. And if it's a hard decision to make and you can't make the decision, I usually err to, okay, well, which one's going to give me greater abundance? And sometimes that can be the deciding factor. This card marks new life, whether it comes in the form of a long-awaited baby. Okay, I forgot about that one. The carnelian represents babies, people wanting to get pregnant or getting pregnant or a new baby being born. But it's the representation of something new, a new beginning in one's life, a new venture, or a great change that's going to make your life much better. This signals the perfect time to birth new ideas and to also restart projects that perhaps have been stuck in the pipeline or that you had to put aside because other things took precedence. Okay, so with this card, what I'm getting in terms of timing is the timing is now. So of all the three piles, this one is very much in the now moment, okay? This is a very fertile time for you, so get your creative juices flowing and focus on all that you would like to bring about. The time is right and your success is assured, so breathe renewed energy into all that has been waiting to come into fruition. So for pile number three, this is essentially a really, truly beautiful full moon. Understand, though, if we want to read each pile starting from 1 to 2 to 3, we can also read it as a pathway where we start with the messages from pile 1 and then we go to the messages of pile 2, and then 3 is the culmination of this lunar eclipse energy, because a lunar eclipse is a bigger energy than just a full moon. A full moon usually speaks of a 29 to 30 day window. A lunar eclipse is about a 6 month window. So if you want to read all the messages here from pile 1, 2 to 3 as what you are traveling throughout these next 6 months, I think that is a beautiful way to approach this. Okay, so that's another format here. But this card is beautiful. Success is guaranteed. There's three messages here. One, success is guaranteed. A new venture is on the way. Second message is there could be an impending birth or an impending pregnancy. And the third one is it's time to fully embrace your creative power. Okay, so those are the three messages. Let's look at the secret language of light to get further guidance here. Follow your inner voice. Isn't that interesting? We have the wishbone with two hands and that wishbone that looks identical on both sides almost. And then here we also have two. And I'm getting a message you may want to apply the energy of number two, which is about coming into balance, coming into harmony. Also, though, an eclipse, especially a lunar eclipse, which is a full moon, is always about the energy of two because it's the moon opposite the sun. It's the second harmonics in numerology and astrology where we're wanting to blend two different energies together to create the third energy. This is beautiful. That looks like an angel taking off. So the message here is listen to your inner voice to achieve further guidance, perhaps. For those of you that have that decision and you're standing at that crossroads, you want to listen to your inner voice right now to get that guidance on which direction to take. Okay? And remember to tune in to your inner compass here. the persistent words and the persistent feelings that you're getting here are your greatest desires dropping into your mind. So pay attention to those feelings that keep coming up, or those words that keep dropping into your mind, or perhaps you keep seeing the same sign or the same number as you're out and about in the world. Sometimes I'll go through a couple days where I keep seeing license plates with the same numbers on them, and that usually is giving me some form of guidance, okay? Remember, your soul wisdom is always leading you towards your destination, okay? But there's a second message with this inner voice. It's okay if in making the decision you're so torn that you choose the left side over the right, and then once you start on the left pathway, you realize that, oh my gosh, I really should have chosen the other one. You can always stop, retrace your steps, and then go back to the other choice. That's what I'm getting here. Remember that even if you go off track, you will not stay that way for very long. It will only be temporary. And understand that all of your guides are going to be directing you back right onto your right path, okay? There may come a time here that you're going to just simply need to make some slight tweaks or adjustments, and just know that sometimes taking an alternate route does give you new direction. It's not taking you off track, it's bringing you to the right direction, but perhaps you're going through the wilderness to get there, okay? So please know that no matter what, you are headed in the right direction here, okay? And please pay attention to how you feel and drive forward on that pathway with a heart, with a smile in your heart and a smile on your face, okay? And so let's look at the very last card from the Queen of the Moon Oracle, and I love it. It's the Full Moon Power. So absolutely, this specific pile is saying the time is now. There is no time like now. And the full moon is you're there, you're embodying who you are, your authentic power. And again, wow, it's so fascinating how we're getting that energy of two there. And it appears here like she has two wings, okay? Just like in this card. So let me see if there's any last minute messages I can get for you from the full moon and power. Number 16 here. Step into your true power. It's time to shine brightly. Do not hide who and what you are. The time is right to now attract big things to yourself. Yep, absolutely. That's what we had in the beginning with the wishbone. Now it's interesting however, with this card, we're getting another message about ancestral energy, which is one of the decks from my last YouTube video. So you may want to go back to that last video and check that out. Ancestral energy is important for you at this time on your journey. Open your mind to larger possibilities so that big magic can actually happen. So opening your life right now to your ancestral line, what I'm getting with that is these are not your immediate ancestors that I'm feeling. These are your ancient ancestors. I'm getting ancient Mesopotamia, the Nile, ancient Egypt, the ancient Gaelic Druidic world in the British Isles. I'm picking up the ancient Mayan culture, the ancient Indonesian shamanistic culture, the tribal cultures that existed out there. So whatever part of the world you feel like tapping into, to your most ancient ancestral line, feel free to call that in at this time as that extra guidance for you. And the last message here from the full moon is that you are made of the very swirling matter that is the stuff of stars. You are pure possibility, changing constantly, renewing and transforming. Take this moment to recognize that power and to rejoice in it. What did I say in the beginning? Celebrate who you are and all that you have achieved. For your next step is the precursor to your future self. Wow, that is a magnificent message. So I want to go ahead and end this entire reading here for all of you that wanted to stay in, and we'll have the timestamps below, to the last messages here from the Whispers of Love. And I wanted to pull these because the planet Neptune just went direct here on November 28th, and it's moving forward. And Neptune moving forward in the sign of Pisces is about making our dreams real and manifest now on the earth plane. So let's look at the guidance. Love makes the difference. Love can help heal past hurts and provides a sense of security, self-worth, and importance. This is asking you to take a leap of faith. This is a card of trust, but it's also a card of taking risks. So it very much aligns with the pile three. Love is what makes the difference. It's love that can heal you. One of the biggest reminders that I have had on my healing journey is I've thought for quite a number of years now, I keep telling my friends and people, I need to heal completely before I want to allow true love in. Whereas the real answer me is that it's love that heals us. It's love that we let in so that the true and final healing can occur. And that's what the message of this card is about, okay? It's about believing in it and trusting in it and taking that leap of faith and choose love. You always have a choice as to what you should do. So this is also directing you at this time and under the umbrella of this eclipse, which lasts for a good 3 to 6 months, that you have a choice. No matter what, you have free will here. You have a choice. And if you're torn between fear and love, work with both of them. Remember, shadow work is important on this journey. You cannot deny your fears and focus only on what's beautiful all the time, because that's a denying some part of yourself that wants to be healed, that wants to be integrated. You have to work with both your fear and your courage at the same time. That is how you become the butterfly in that picture. And I love it because there's children dancing. There's a lot of joy to be had in this card. So it's saying to you, choose joy. Choose friendship, choose partnership, choose to emerge as that beautiful butterfly, okay? And for others, I'm getting that this is a message that there are choices in love that are awaiting you and that you might have to make a choice between two different people or even three or four, that there might be more than one or two choices here. And so sit with it. But make sure that the choice you make is truly based on love and on your joy and what your heart truly desires. And you know what? I knew this card was going to come up. I could feel it pulling at me from the deck on my shelf. The union of hearts. There is a connection of love that defies explanation. So the end of this journey here with Neptune direct and the eclipse is that each and every one of us is moving into this true love journey. However we get there, we want to have that true love within ourselves. We want to embody that inner balance with our masculine and feminine. We want to love ourselves like this tree is loving itself. That is how profoundly we want to love ourselves. And we also want to bring in a divine counterpart who loves and adores the very ground that we walk on. That is a beautiful message. And it's a message telling you that it's this true love that awaits you. And that is the final message here today. I love you all and I wish you so well on this beautiful journey of love, self-realization, and emergence.